this is a spanner and you want to turn the nut. So this is the nut over here. You want to turn the nut in a clockwise manner. So which section will require the smallest force? So you want to loosen the nut. The moment that's required to loosen this nut is fixed. All right. If you tighten the nut a lot, then you need a larger moment to loosen it. But in this, so the moment that you require is fixed. So what you want to do is you want to have as small, we want to use as small a force as possible. So since F times D gives you the moment, if you want to use a small force, then what you have to do is you need to multiply by the small force with a bigger number here, D. And you can actually increase the D by ensuring that you apply the force further away from the pivot. So this is actually your D from here to here. So the furthest you can use is, of course, the furthest you can hold the spanner is then at position D. So that's part one. Draw an arrow to show the direction. When you draw the arrow, you've got to show it 90 degrees because if you apply the force at 90 degrees, it gives the, at this position at 90 degrees, you have the largest D. If you apply at any other angle, actually your D will be smaller, right? So always apply it perpendicularly. And for part B, this is a question that says you want to balance the seesaw. There are two persons on the seesaw. So each of them will give a turning moment. So the plumber will give a clockwise moment. You will cause the seesaw to turn clockwise. The sun will cause it to turn anti-clockwise. So what then, how then can you balance it? Well, it will be balanced if these two values are the same. So the plumber's position has been fixed. So the force is 750, that's the weight of the plumber, times 4, which is the distance between the plumber and the pivot. And the sun can actually still adjust his position, right? So his weight is fixed. And the distance I'm going to determine. So this is the sun's anti-clockwise moment. This is the father's clockwise moment. And if they are equal, the seesaw will be balanced. So from here, you do some mathematical manipulation, and you know that the sun got to sit 6 meters away from the